powerful bear hug will drain all the air out of your lungs.
Squeeze out of my lungs.
This could be the end right here.
Look at the face on Paul Ellery, the intensity, how closely he's watching this one. The Legion of Doom wants those world championship belts back. Animal just squeezing the breath right out of Mr. Electricity. With that nickname, Scott, I don't think there's very much voltage going through his body right now.
Yeah, that's exactly right. It kind of looks like a burnout bulb at this moment. Not much juice flowing from Mr. Electricity right now.
Regal trying vainly to get to his corner to tag to Garvin. He makes the tag.
Oh, they do make the tag.
Animal doesn't know it. Animal has no idea that they have tagged.
Oh, he's got that mighty bear hug on gorgeous Jimmy Garvin now, squeezing the life out of him.
You talk about somebody that's played possum.
Oh, high off the rope. Oh, flying punch right to the head. Jimmy Garvin down, Hawk cuts him. Oh, he gets his shoulder up. I don't think Hawk really wanted him that time. I think maybe they want to savor this and just give these two a little punishment. Oh, big stomp off the second rope. Referee backs him up a little. Oh, just takes him by the hair and hurls him across the ring.
So far in this one, it has been all, and I do mean all, Road Warriors.
Oh, big elbow smash to the top of the head. Garvin's in pretty serious trouble now.
Oh!
Garvin managed to kick the Hawk. I think he telegraphed that backdrop just a little too soon. That's what I mentioned earlier. These two are pretty cagey wrestlers, and they're going to take advantage of any opportunity they can.
They have held the belts, and the reason being, like a good football team, they capitalize to the fullest any mistakes their opponents make. Now,
look at the look in the Hawk's eyes. Slowly stalking Regal now. I think they really are enjoying this.
They came right out and said they wanted to deal out as much punishment. Take a look at Paul Ellering.
Oh, high above his head. He's got him by the throat, high above his head.
And just drops him like a sack of last week's garbage. The Road Warriors, the Hawk, in the ring against Mr. Electricity. Oh, that looked an awful lot like a judo chop right to the throat.
That's exactly right. I'll tell you, there's no love lost between these two teams. It looks like they're throwing out the rule book tonight. They just want to punish them. A win's not enough. The Road Warriors want to deal out some punishment tonight.
But they want to take those belts back home with them. They feel that they were embarrassed by a team of Garvin and Regal, being outweighed as much as they do.
Big power slam by the Animal. And there's Jimmy Garvin to make the save.
Garvin
just one more time, how you have to point out, Ken. They may not be able to match up with size with the Road Warriors, but they're pretty sneaky, shifty guys. They're going to take advantage. You know, they've defended the world belt several times since they've had them, and they're a pretty capable wrestling team.
You and Kurt Hennig have had a shot at dethroning the champions, and as you said, somehow they always manage to come out on top by hook or crook.
Well, one thing I noticed tonight, absent, you don't see Precious at ringside. You have to wonder if she's lurking around the building somewhere. She often plays a hand in many of their victories.
No doubt about it. Very good point, Scott. The Warriors have let it be known that if Precious was anywhere in ringside, if she tried to interfere in the match, there's no telling what they were going to do to her either. So perhaps gorgeous Jimmy Garvin decided the safety of his valet was as important.
Well, the Road
as
Warriors
else.
Have a Precious one themselves in their corner. Precious Paul Ellering, their manager, and I'm sure he'd be keeping an eye on Garvin and Regal's Precious, should she appear.
Could be one reason why she's not here.
Steve Regal backs into the corner trying to tag. Jimmy Garvin seems to want nothing to do with this.
Now, it truly looked like Garvin deliberately.
Oh, he's over there trying to tag now. Perhaps he didn't see his partner there, but I don't know, Ken. Looked like a deliberate way to stay out of the ring. Here comes the Hawk in.
Now what are they going to do? Hawk up on
Hawk
the second rope.
Hawk up on the second rope. Oh! Flying shoulder from the second rope. You know, the Road Warriors are such agile men. He's so big. It amazes me every time I see them. The agility of these two men. Both big and muscular, yet able to fly around that wrestling ring.
Regal calling for a timeout. Warriors were having none of it.
Oh,
he missed the clothesline.
Oh!
He caught him with a
boot. Big boot right under the chin. And Regal's in trouble now. He's asking for mercy, but he'll get none from the Road Warriors.
You can bet your last dollar on that. Hawk hammers away at the forehead of Steve Regal. Picks him up, field throw, takes it out of the mat. Now it goes into a front gym line.
Oh, yeah, with those big arms on there, he's really putting a lot of pressure on the
Shannon. Arms of the Hawk.
He strains, squeezing Regal's chin back. It's really hard to breathe when you're in that particular hold. I'm sure Steve Regal's thinking about tagging now. What he needs is to tag in his fresh partner, Jimmy Garvin. Get over there on the apron and take a breather. Oh, big knee lift. Down goes Regal one more time.
Now Hawk again up on the second rope.
He missed the big splash. Hawk's trying for the corner, trying to tag an animal. And Garvin and Regal seize the opportunity. Anytime they get a chance to take advantage, they pounce on it.
We talked about it, and they are probably the most opportunistic tag team champions we've seen in a long time.
Exactly
they wait
right
for their opponents to make a mistake, and they pounce. You cannot take that away from them.
They're very intelligent wrestlers. Anything they lack in size, they make up with technique.
And speed. Very, very quick.
In and out, a lot of quick tags.
Now,
a lot of teamwork, a lot of double teaming, whatever they can do.
Choked away.
They got him in their corner now. And it looks like Garvin's using the tag rope.
Referee busy trying to keep the animal back. Garvin and Regal, two on one.
There they are, double teaming, using the rope. Any advantage they can gain.
And once again, driving this back referee, Chris Pepper, Regal continues to use that rope, blatantly choking. The Hawk now rakes the fingers across the nose and eyes. Now, Garvin sets him up. What's he going to do?
It looks like it. Tried for the pile driver. No, he can't get him. He's got him now.
Oh!
A mighty pile driver. And look at the Hawk.
Look at the Hawk.
Shakes his head a little bit and gets right up. You know, that's a move that's ended a lot of men's careers. The pile driver, a lot of people think it should be banned from professional wrestling. I don't think Hawk's one of them. Doesn't bother him one bit.
Maybe a little discontent. Steve Regal did not like the idea of Garvin coming over and tagging him so quickly. Now the Hawk tags off to the animal, so we've got two
fresh men.
Look at the Hawk flex those pectoral muscles. He's got Regal in a headlock. A tremendous crowd on hand here for this tag team championship battle from the Winnipeg Arena.
It certainly is, and a very enthusiastic crowd. They seem to really be having a good time tonight.
What a great, great city Winnipeg is. Tremendous sports
certainly
town.
The favorite town for me, Ken. I love to come up here. They always take good care of us over there at the Polo Park Inn. The fans here are so receptive. That long trip well worth it.
Yes, they do. I get that
long. Cover. And once again, Garvin didn't make the save. But this time, there's no holding back the animal. There's no holding back the animal.
Look out.
Flailing on him in the corner.
We've got all four men in the ring.
It looks like they're trying to. Oh, a quick reversal. They send Garvin and Regal together, and both men go to the mat.
The Legion of Doom in high gear and high animal trust.
They throw Garvin out. The referee seems to be knocked
Regal
down. Someone needs to get the referee
Chris
up.
Pepper. He's dazed. But meanwhile, the Warriors going after Steve Regal.
Animal goes to the top. Animal set himself on the top